and welcome to the second episode of a very special interaction we are having with the SEBI chairman, C.B. Bhave. We are calling it the midterm review. Half of his three-year term, 18th of August is when that happens, and we are talking about a lot more of issues that SEBI is faced with right now. Last episode, we talked about mutual fund reforms as well as IPOs. Today, about investigations and orders that SEBI has passed. Mr. Bhave, thanks so much for joining us once again on this very special show. Let me focus now back on the entities you're supposed to regulate, which is, of course, the exchanges and the listed entities. There has been a lot of controversy about how companies behave in this country. One issue which came to light was in the backdrop of the crisis, the pledging of shares aspect of it. Let's start from there and how the companies behaved. A lot of people say some companies were on the verge of closure, yet everybody revived. Good for the entrepreneurial spirit of the country. But do you think the loopholes were so many in the system that companies could not go under and hence survived and somehow have come back into the mainstream?
Look, I do not know how companies survived and so on, but as far as the disclosure of pledging of shares by promoters is concerned, that is something people complied with. We have about 500 companies disclosing what kind of pledges were made by them, and investors made their own decisions.
Are you saying that the system is foolproof, that they were not able to bypass the system by doing it in a holding company and actually bypassing the public eye altogether?
No system is foolproof, one. Second thing, it is possible for people to pledge the shares of a company which in turn is holding the shares of this company. This issue did come up in our primary market advisory committee, and the committee said that once we have formulated this rule that pledge should be disclosed and it has been under implementation for some time, let us revisit this issue. So my guess is that this committee will again look at this issue and then advise the board on what it thinks is the right course to follow.
As the SEBI chairman, what do you think should be desirable? As a shareholder, you and I should know every time the promoter is doing anything to do with the stake in the listed company.
Yeah, that is right. But we would take a view in this matter only after we get advice from the primary market.
But as a shareholder, I mean, what should I expect according to you? You're the SEBI chairman. Of course, there's a committee that you have to comply with. But as a shareholder, don't you think we are obliged to be told what the promoter does with the stake in the listed entity?
Yeah, which is what our requirement today is. But we are saying, do we need to go beyond that and see what he's doing in unlisted companies as well?
Which affect the listed entity the end of the day. As of today, you're satisfied with the way the system is? I mean, you don't think there are lacunas in the system?
Well, as I told you, no system is foolproof and no system is capable of saying that I don't need any improvement. So we have to constantly strive to improve. I mean, all these days, the pledge of shares was never disclosed. We have taken one step. We need to take many more steps to be more and more transparent.
Ministry of Corporate Affairs might be looking at even transactions less than 1% to be made public. Do you think those things will help at all?
I don't know. We already have rules about what kind of transactions need to be made public. One could have a debate on whether that number is right or some other number is right.
Overall, as SEBI chairman, as a midterm review, how do you generally feel the behavior of corporates has been? I'm not even talking about Satyam right now, but generally speaking, as a person who has overseen this, are you satisfied that the quality of governance, the quality of corporate behavior has been pretty much steady?
You know, it is a little risky to paint all Indian corporates with one brush. Like any sample of 100, you have some excellent corporate governance examples, you will have examples where corporate governance isn't to the desirable level. So I wouldn't want to paint them all with the same brush. But if you were to look at the transition from, let us say, 2000 onwards, we've come a long way. We should be happy with that, but we shouldn't be content with it because we still have a long way to go.
Tubar.com.